Welcome back to this another weekly tech tip with me Atul Kumar from Team Ketonine Academy, and today we are going to look at networking in Oracle Cloud, specifically Oracle Cloud Infrastructure or OCI. So we'll look at how to connect from on-premise to cloud. There are three different ways, including Fast Connect and VPN. Then within cloud, we'll look at things like virtual cloud network, subnets, different type of gateways, that's internet gateway, dynamic routing gateways. When you create a machine on Oracle Cloud, how does that machine get an IP address? So everything related to networking. But before that, let me give you some context. Now, cloud is typically divided into three service models. One is software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. Everything today we are going to discuss is all from the third part, that's infrastructure as a service. So if you're new, I did a video in one of the previous tech tips that you can watch on our blog, which is ketoninacademy.com/cloud02, which is on the screen here. So in that I covered about this service model. So if you're new, then make sure you watch that service model video. That's ketoninacademy.com/cloud02. So as I mentioned that there are three service models, and when you talk about the networking, it's mainly with respect to infrastructure as a service. Now, Oracle has a rich offering in infrastructure as a service, and they have all this like OCI, OCI Classic, Container Native Applications, Revelo, Clouded Customer. So first understand that there are two different type of IaaS. One is Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Classic, and second is Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. So the difference between these two, I've explained it in ketoninacademy.com/OCI12. And if you want to know more about OCI, if you're a complete beginner on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, then a high level concept are in OCI 11. So ketoninacademy.com/OCI11. So in this video, we're going to focus about the networking module or networking part in Oracle Public Cloud or Oracle Cloud Infrastructure to be more specific. So what you see diagram, the black outer box, this represents a Oracle Public Cloud. And so if an extreme left, that is a customer data center or machines from where you are connecting. So there are three main methods to connect to Oracle Public Cloud. One is over the internet. So what you do, these boxes, which are red internal boxes, small boxes, these are represented here. These represents a machine. So let's suppose this machine has a IP address assigned to them. If you want to connect without Fast Connect or without VPN from the internet, you will be defining or you'll be setting up a public IP on this machine, and the port number 22, which is a SSH port or a remote desktop port, if it's a Windows machine, then those ports should be open and that machine should be having a public IP. So one method is connecting over the internet using on the port 22 or remote desktop port if it's Windows, but on public IP. However, as you know, you don't want to open or expose these machines to the internet as it's not safe. So other two methods to connect are VPN, which stands for Virtual Private Network, or Fast Connect. So the main two methods to connect from customer's data center onto Oracle Cloud is VPN, which is IPsec, Virtual Private Network Tunnel. And then second is Fast Connect. The major two differences between Fast Connect and VPN is that for VPN, the connection will still go over the internet, but it's on a SSL tunnel between the customer data center and on Oracle Public Cloud. Whereas in Fast Connect, there's a dedicated pipe, which is a high bandwidth network pipe between the customer data center and Oracle Public Cloud. Now, Fast Connect is definitely more expensive because it's point to point and used if you have a high bandwidth usage or requirement between customer data center and Oracle Public Cloud. Now let's come to the main topic within Oracle Public Cloud. What are the various networking components? So what you see here, outer dotted lines, this is a virtual cloud network, and virtual cloud network is specific to a region. And here you see availability domain. Now, within availability domain, you see subnet. So what is availability domain? What is subnet? And what are other things like VCN and region that I mentioned? It's important for you to understand that these concepts first before we go on to the networking concept. So first, region is nothing but a geographical location on which Oracle's public cloud are. And within OCI context, as of September 2018, there are four regions in which Oracle public cloud is there. Two are in US, one is in Germany, Frankfurt, and fourth one is in London. And this is situation as of September 2018, but more and more these regions are coming. Public cloud within a country that represents a region. Now, then you also have a availability domain, and it's important to understand the availability domain because subnets are assigned per availability domain, or the compute or the machines that you create within Oracle Cloud infrastructure are specific to availability domain. So what are availability domain? Availability domain are nothing but three data centers within a region which are interconnected by a high bandwidth, low latency network. So these availability domain provides high availability within a Oracle public cloud within a region. So just to repeat, in a region, you will have three availability domain for fault tolerance, for high availability within Oracle public cloud. And why it's important for you to know, understand availability domain is because subnet you're going to create or machines that you're going to create on top of OCI are specific to availability domain. I'll explain that subnet in a minute. So let's first begin with, now you understand a region, now you understand the availability domain. Let's begin with first virtual cloud network. What is virtual cloud network? So the dotted line which you see here, that represents one virtual cloud network. So what exactly is virtual cloud network? It's nothing but a software defined version of your traditional physical network. So in within your on-premise, whatever network you create, similar to that, in a software version of that on Oracle public cloud is virtual cloud network. So VCN resides within a region. So let's suppose you can have multiple regions. Your Oracle cloud account can be in multiple regions. So one you have in EMEA, which is London, and second is in US. So you have two regions. However, the virtual cloud network will be within a region. So if you have two region, or if your cloud account has two regions or subscribe to two regions, then you'll be creating at least two virtual cloud networks. So the VCN resides within a region. Now, VCN in one region can talk to VCN in another region across. There's something called as remote VCN peering, which I'll tell a little bit later. So VCN covers a single contiguous IPv4 CIDR block. So what you see in right hand side, these are CIDRs. So CIDR 16 represents 65,536 machines. So in a simple terms, in a virtual cloud network, you're defining the networks. So within that network with the CIDR 16, you can create 65,000 machines, or you get 65,000 IPs. CIDR 30, you can create up to 4 machines. So VCN allows a CIDR range from 16 to 30. You can create a maximum 65,000 in a network. So that's VCN. So the first thing you'll be doing before doing anything on Oracle public cloud or OCI is creating a network. So let me show you how to create a virtual cloud network. You go from hamburger menu and then go to networking and you say virtual cloud network. Make sure you pick an appropriate compartment, right compartment in which you would like to create a network, and you say create virtual cloud network. And here you'll be defining and creating a virtual cloud network. As I said, you give a CIDR block. So I'm giving 10.10.0.0 and then 16. I can have IP addresses between 10.10.0.0 to 10.10.255.255. Because I've selected here 16, which means first to 8 here on first P and 8 here second 16, I can't change. Whereas I can change these last two IPs or last two octane in this IP range. Now simply click on create virtual cloud network, and this will create a virtual cloud network for me, or VCN for me. Now VCN is good. However, VCN is a big network. Now, managing this bigger network becomes difficult. Moreover, you want to, or usually applications are done or deployed in usually three-tier architecture, what we call DMZ, application tier, and database tier. So the bigger network is further broken down into smaller network, and that's what is subnet. Now, when you define subnet, so within VCN, you'll be breaking down or creating subnets. And subnets are specific to availability domain. Remember, I explained about what is availability domain. Three data centers within a geographical location, which are interconnected to provide high availability and business continuity. So the subnets will be specific to availability domain. So if you notice, I'm going to create subnets within a virtual cloud network. So I created this virtual cloud network, which is K21 VCN01 here. I click here inside that, and here you see subnet 0. That means there is no subnet within this VCN. I can go and create subnets. So the IP addresses for subnet will be ranges that fall within or under my virtual cloud network. For my VCN CIDR was 10.10.0.0.16. So I can only give within that range. So I'll here say then K21 subnet 01. And now I'm going to say which availability domain. As I said, told you that subnet is tied to an availability domain. So I'll select availability domain 1. And now CIDR block, because I've selected earlier 10.10. I can pick here 1. I can change either this or, and then 0, 16, 24. Let's suppose I select 24, this range, which means I can't change first three. I can only change the last bit, which is 10.10.1. will stay static. And then last bit from a 0 to 255, I can change these IPs. Now, when you create a subnet, that subnets can be a public or private. Again, this public and private will be used when you're exposing it to the internet, or when you're exposing machines to a internet, or when you're deploying the load balancer. I'll explain that security list as well in a minute. So you create, and you've created a subnet. So your subnet, it's a smaller part of your bigger network, that's VCN, and broken down into smaller part, that subnet. Then you go and create compute. So compute is nothing but your machines that you create on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. That could be a Windows machine or a Linux machine. So when you create a compute, then you create that compute, or you attach it or to a subnet. So if you notice here, I went into menu item and instances, and under when I'm creating instance, I'm assigning a subnet to that, and the compute is going to pick up IP addresses randomly from within this subnet range. So I gave that range 10.10.1 and then 10.10.1. So it can pick up any range from 10.10.1 dot something and then 10.10.1 dot something between 0 to 255. So it can pick up that. I can also assign a dedicated IP to that. So whatever machines I'm going to create, my compute is going to pick up machines from that subnet. So I hope you understand now, virtual cloud network is a bigger network broken down into smaller network subnet, and the machines will be assigned or pick up its IP addresses from the subnet to which this machine is part of. Then you have security list and route tables. So security lists are nothing but firewalls that protect that particular subnet. So you create security list and attach them to a subnet. So security list will represent nothing but a firewall. So anything going out or coming into the subnet or going out for the subnet should be allowed from that firewall, which is nothing but security list. And a route table represents any connection going out from that subnet. How do they go out? How the request will route out based on these routing tables. So security list, route tables. So this is in a high level basic concept covering virtual cloud network, which is a CIDR block, then a subnet, which is broken down, or bigger network broken down to a smaller part specific to availability domain, and compute pick up their IP addresses from the subnet's IP range, and then you have a security list and route tables. Now, OCI VPN, I told you that there are two different ways to connect from your customer data center, which is OCI Virtual Private Network. It's a IP security based VPN tunnel between on-premise and to Oracle Public Cloud. Fast Connect is a dedicated pipe, which or high bandwidth pipe between the Oracle, your customer premises and Oracle Public Cloud. Now, the dynamic routing gateway and internet gateway, these are two gateways and they have a specific purpose. So when your customer data center wants to talk to the Oracle Cloud using Fast Connect or VPN, one end of that tunnel is going to be something called as customer premise equipment or your router premise or router endpoint at a customer side. Similar to that, there'll be another endpoint you need on Oracle Public Cloud. That endpoint will be represented by dynamic routing gateway. So it's a virtual object that you create in Oracle Cloud infrastructure. So dynamic routing gateway is always to connect a Oracle Public Cloud virtual cloud network to the customer data center, or one virtual cloud network to another virtual cloud network. We'll see that why you need that virtual cloud network connectivity. So dynamic routing gateway, always to connect either on-premise or to another virtual cloud network. So to see how does a dynamic routing gateway or DRG, it's a logical, look like in OCI, you go to menu item and networking and dynamic routing gateway. You create a dynamic routing gateway and then you can attach it to a virtual cloud network or detach it and attach to another virtual cloud network or VCN. Then you have an internet gateway. So internet gateway is another gateway that is used to connect a public subnet to the internet. So let's suppose you have a subnet and you want to create some machines that should be able to connect to the internet or talk to the internet. So what you're going to do, you're going to create an internet gateway and attach that internet gateway or make a routing table from public subnet onto the internet gateway to go all the way to internet. So the role of internet gateway is to connect a machine within virtual cloud network onto the internet. Now, other important thing you should know about is VCN peering. Now, you know about virtual cloud network. You can create multiple virtual cloud networks for different to control different machines, or you can have a different networks. You can connect these two or different virtual cloud network within a region using VCN peering. The process of connecting virtual cloud network is called as VCN peering, and when you connect two VCNs within a region, that's called as local peering. So if you see here, the left hand side, you see one VCN, both are in single region, VCN 1 and VCN 2. These two are talking to each other and that process is local VCN peering, and they connect to each other using a component called local peering gateway. So you will have one local peering gateway in VCN 1, second local peering gateway on VCN 2, and then local peering gateway 1 will talk to local peering gateway 2. And that's how one virtual cloud network can talk to another virtual cloud network in Oracle Public Cloud. So that's local VCN peering. Now you can have a peering across regions or peering between VCNs across region. So you can have a virtual cloud network in region 1 and another virtual cloud network on region 2. Now if you want a machine in VCN 1 to talk to the machine in VCN 2, you can configure a concept called remote VCN peering, by which VCN in one region can talk to the VCN in another region. So your VCN will talk to the component called remote peering connection on the region 1, and there'll be similarly remote peering connection on the region 2, and these two will talk to each other. So that's remote VCN peering. And it's important if you're configuring things like disaster recovery or you have a data center across regions for disaster recovery, then the remote VCN peering plays a very important role. So these are some of the basic networking concept. Now, of course, I've covered a very high level. Let me do a quick recap about the concept that we learned related to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure networking. So we looked at virtual cloud network, which is a virtual representation of networking or networks similar to on-premise. It is within a region. Now you break down this big virtual cloud network into smaller networks that we call subnet. The compute machines or machines that you create will pick up the IP addresses from this subnet. Then you protect a security layer to the subnet. That's called a security list, which is nothing but a firewall that dictates what connection can go out or come back in within a subnet. You define a routing table to connect from the subnets onto the gateways like dynamic routing gateway or internet gateway. And then you have two methods to connect, which is VPN, which is nothing but IP security VPN tunnel or fast connect. Then you have a dynamic routing gateway that is used to connect your cloud or Oracle public cloud to on-premise, or to connect one virtual cloud network in one region to a virtual cloud network in another region. Internet gateway is to connect a subnet within Oracle public cloud to internet. And then you have VCN peering, which is connecting two virtual cloud networks. So you have local VCN peering, which is VCN within a region. And then you have a remote VCN peering, which is the connecting two virtual cloud networks across a region. Well, that's it for today from me, Atul Kumar. Now, if you like this video, then don't forget to share it with your colleagues. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and also to our blog. So you can go to ketoninacademy.com/blog, and on right hand side, you can enter your name and email address and click on subscribe now so you can get all the notifications related to as soon as we blog or create a new content related to Oracle or cloud, you get notification. Also, if you have not yet started your cloud journey, I would like to invite you for a 7 days free trial to getting started with Oracle Public Cloud and getting Oracle Cloud Architect certified. It's a comprehensive step-by-step course with hands-on activity guide where we cover 10 plus modules, including certification quiz related to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Certification 1Z0932. And if you want to try, go to ketoninacademy.com/trycloud for a 7 days free trial. Thank you for listening. Now, with that, action for you is go and create your account on Oracle Public Cloud. If you don't know how to create an account on public cloud, go to this URL, which is ketoninacademy.com/cloud01, and get a copy so that you will get it immediately in your email, a step-by-step activity guide on how to register for Oracle Public Cloud, and you can start practicing what I've covered, or at least start looking at this network, what I've shown you today. I'll see you next week.